40 years ago, China was at a crossroads.
1978年，中国老百姓买什么东西啊，都很短缺。
广播呢都管他饿，肥皂呢又没什么保温体嘛。
也得好多白手铁是铁铁就是他就是这样。
But in 1978, a visionary leader set the country on a bold new course.
Deng Xiaoping was saying, release the economy.
We've got to let the farmers breathe.
The era of reform and opening up has given China economic rocket boosters.
Propelled onwards by reforms in the countryside, China reinvented itself at breakneck speed.
这样呢，为农民尽快的富裕创造了一条这个新路。
It wasn't always easy.
We're talking about the transformation of 1/5 of humanity. It's not like throwing a lever.
那个是晚上，我刚才是五个晚上睡着醒过来，一身冷汗。
But hard work and ambitious thinking got their rewards.
The transformation is incredible.
China has basically become a different kind of a country.
通过自己的努力来改变自己的命运。
This is China's story. Today, China is a country of vast, glittering cities. But just 40 years ago, things were very different. Most people were poor farmers living in the countryside, working for a system which didn't allow them to reach their full potential. But then, in 1978, a series of groundbreaking reforms began, which gradually opened China up to free market economics, transforming the lives of millions. We're going to meet just a few. The farmer who's on a mission to help her ancient village prosper. The billionaire businessman who battled to escape his past.
就是爸爸妈妈为了让我们吃饱，他们就少吃一点。
The father and son who seized their chances.
大家都分了这个分了地了，都给这样土哎，努力这个劳动，都改变这个生活。
The entrepreneur who revolutionized farming.
我说我通过科学技术来帮助农村来发展，帮助农民提高收益。
The left behind farmer making a fresh start in a brand new village.
哎呀，在我以后的包括生活的看点跟以前刚才会不一样了，这生活是看点是越来越好。
Ordinary and extraordinary people.Whose journeys all offer a window into China's astonishing and unexpected rise. Over the past 40 years, China's era of reform and opening up has unleashed opportunities which have transformed its rural regions. This is the ancient village of Gertou in mountainous Guizhou province.It's a microcosm of the changes China has seen. Here, local villagers once lived a hand-to-mouth existence. But as the country has grown richer, they've been given a lifeline.
There's an old saying, you know, in China, if you want to make your village prosperous, build a road.
As roads go in, people's lives change.
Up until 2008,Yangqing's village, Gertou, was cut off from the outside world.
像以前的话，没有交通的话，父母就只能在这个村里面读个小学，就最多就读个初中，就这样就结束了，就不可能去接受更多的教育了。
也就是你个嘴呢，给个大就得给你有协调了。你个鞋就得给个细条儿嘞，你谁单个谁的谁你嘞，没得妈来来拉来我洗裤呢。
而现在的话呢，我们道路都通到家门口。
啊，就给拖到走，拖给走开这些老路嘞，这里都弄不塞的。 我想办法了，看弄些路。那到年你我不是都能来收入了，对，谁可以过？
我发呀！噱头啊！
Village carpenter Lee also started a new business thanks to the road.
我做的茶叶，两个月赚的钱，比我做木工差不多一年的工价。
大陆修建以后呢，他们到外面去学到更好的技艺。得到更多新的理念，然后再回到我们格斗村来。我大学毕业之后呢，一直在这个从事保护我们苗族传统的技艺。然后呢，具体的工作就是教我们一些农村妇女去做一些传统的苗族传统的一些技艺，因为我们这些苗族传统的这些技艺呢，不断在失传。
With those roads, with those communication, they have access. People suddenly have, of course, they have changes in their life.
Since reforms began in 1978, hundreds of millions of people in China's countryside have seen their living standards rise. Today, Xi Jinping's government has placed renewed emphasis on raising the remaining extremely poor out of poverty.
We have been living here for 40 years. I've been living here for 19 years. This is a huge deal. This is a huge deal. This is a huge deal.我大女儿给不回来。
Here in Shanxi province, an ambitious targeted poverty alleviation project is aimed at improving people's living conditions. In a brand new village, built from scratch.
我那个好快就搬过去了，搬过去，我往后的生活是越来越好。尤其是我们在这面这没点个东西也不方便，11:30往外就有一个人才来买东西了。
这是我往走一半，村里头这没车的根本就不来了。
都想和子女少抓着枪法了，那面一天，这面一天，这跑出来的还挺有想象。
三五天吧，我赶着去搬家去。最后我把我爹小爹子我搬到小村。
来了，丈夫谁来都满意。哎呀，看看男孩都满意。
可怜嘛，他说他是爹，他就起床，起床就说，到天吧，你上月是，哦，这炕就可热的。
Today, new villages like this one are places of hope and opportunity. But before reform and opening up, it was a very different story.
In 1978, 60% of the Bian Chinese at the time lived on a dollar a day.
Agriculture in China was collectivized. Every person was organized into a production brigade and produced crops according to the dictates of the state.
农民没有任何的自主权，受到了严格的制约。
只有通过自己努力去劳动，把这个现状改变好。
As a young man, Yao Ming Rue labored on a collectivized farm in southeast China.
天冷的时候，最早烤板，大家就起好，分配工作去干活， 也去铲除草，他去犁田，他去挑粪，他去挑水。我们是一家有七个人吧，就三个劳动力，早上去西多，工作呢都管他我，回来呢又没什么保温梯嘛。大概就是一种劳动嘛，反正我一个劳动力一天休分，我就过一天就记下来，去过工分才三毛钱，就有天呢就不想干，他就找赵桥，他也哪样的工分，你多管哪样的，他小管哪样的，这叫管道很不公平嘛。
Now many of these collective farms had essentially broken down.
There was almost a kind of lethargic attitude.
And so in 1978, China was about to move in a very different direction.
In 1978, China's planned economy was holding back progress. But something was stirring in the countryside.
In 1978, a celebrated experiment happened in this small little village, Xiaogang, in Anhui province.
Farmers, frustrated by collectivization, began to go it alone.
A group of families made a deal that they would provide the state with the official state planned quota, but after that, they would sell their own food and they would keep the profit.
What happened? Output the next year was five times as high as the previous year.
The results were remarkable. With the household responsibility system, which is what the system became known as, people were free to be as entrepreneurial as they wished.
The new system went against the very idea of a planned economy. But in Beijing, China's leaders saw its potential and introduced a new, freer way for farmers to work.
当时这个第一把的一开一开的嘛，每家每户都能分到一些。当时这个地是分给我的嘛，还这边开，还有这边开嘛。当时这个地原来是不属于我们的，现在属于我了，我很高兴了。这时候我二十二岁嘛，年轻，有冠军嘛，把这个生活搞得美好。
一下子迸发出了农民巨大的这种生产热情，巨大的创造精神。
They would just spontaneously roll out a piece of cloth and start to sell vegetables. People were so excited.
Farmers had more capacity to sell part of their produce for profit, and as a result, they could accumulate cash and begin to think more about developing their own personal circumstances and lifestyles.
我家里呢，对，这小的，就回来呢就可以给小孩做买衣服，买点好吃的哦。这个本本也大了，这个系统蛮大，买什么东西有，多了，蛮小的，这个，分量都不挑，我们这个，房子啊，都建了这个两千的、三千的，有的建了几吨都有。这个基本都是这个摩托车、小车。
Now that farms were so much more productive, far fewer people were needed to work the land.
What do you do with this excess labor? You start producing industrial products in the rural areas.
One of the products of that early period of economic reform was the setting up of TVEs, Township and Village Enterprises.
And all kinds of businesses developed and sprung up overnight.
It created a kind of frisson, of excitement.
TVEs were started by a new breed of rural entrepreneur, young, ambitious, and hungry for success.Like the remarkable billionaire Gao Derkang from rural Jiangsu province, who built his small business into a clothing empire.
At
当初我就立志要长大以后要做一个对国家啊，对我们那个当地要有用的人了。
哎喂，
哎来试一下。哎，快点，慢点，乖哥。
这个。
哦，那快一转压下来个。
哎喂喂。
哦。
But his journey to the top was far from easy.
我们那个小时候呢，非常贫穷，那个时候说实话吃不饱的。从原来人那个脚踩那个粗屎啊打的，那个时候稻田就是啊靠这种，大部分都是人工的。我爸爸妈妈都是一个务实做农田的人。我妈妈当初也做过生产队的妇女队长，她是一直是带好头的。我们是八个人住，然后妈妈、那个爸爸还有我爷爷，我们姊妹五个，加起来八个人，60平方，非常艰辛艰苦，所以我认为很痛苦。一个我妈妈要管好五个，要做鞋子要做好多鞋子了。那个时候没有什么皮鞋，没有买的鞋子，都是布鞋。我妈妈就是很辛苦。他每个都要住，让我们要过得好一点。五个你，
哎，这里的小弟呢，小苦恼的，来了没都没有压上来。
好一个，
修车的。
现在，那不要讲，现在是比较开心的。后来刚刚开始吃生产光，屋里是比较苦的，苦了穷了不得了。那个阳光呢，一毛钱。前面这一段经历都有，都艰苦的事情应该告个段落。
When he was 20, Derkung started a small tailoring group.
I want to make a, not only to make this tailoring, I want to make a leader of a team. My company, I go to make it. This risk is taken to make myself become a member. I am not afraid. If I do this, I will not have a path to the top. No path to the top, I will not have a path to the top.
When people have the opportunity to escape from poverty, it is like an elemental human force.
赚了这点钱呢，我就马上呢去增添了一个自行车。我自行车呢就来去上海到叫我们公司啊200公里。我们一天要在早晨五点钟起来，一直到12点那个回来。那么更多的时间就是借着月光的亮度，我们回到家里。就路上有的是下雨，刮风下雨啊，都是非常艰难的。我就是认为感受到了，经历过了，那我心里有强大的就内涵，就是我就什么都好像不怕的。我们后来就是拿衣服越来越多，工厂又开又大。
In the 1980s, China's rural transformation wasn't just about the growth of small factories. Farming itself was continuing to evolve.
我认为啊，每个人都会有梦。我们创业的时候呢，我的梦想是什么？一定程度地改变农村的面貌。
Liu Yonghao and his daughter Angela run New Hope Group, today China's leading agricultural business.
我觉得我爸爸是一个充满好奇心的人，然后非常非常的有企业家精神。
我女儿安杰拉，她可以说见证了我们企业的进步。
不管遇到什么样的一些情况下，好的时候、不好的时候，她都保持自己和这个组织永远都有学习能力和自我革命的这样一种能力。
因为中国决定开放的时候，我们刚好大学毕业不久，我们还年轻，我们有几个兄弟，我们非常拼搏，但是我们始终在看。而那个时候改革开放刚刚开始不久，而农村呢已经有了专业户啊。在82年的时候呢，我们就想到我们是不是可以做些事儿了，是不是时候到了。
Their big ideawas to produce food on an industrial scale.
辞去教师的职务，到农村去创业一些鹌鹑，所以说受到了很多的非难。有时候走在街上，后边的这个人就指指点点，你看他就是什么什么老师，好好的老师不做，去做一些不三不四的事儿。这个时候我假装没听见。我们养鸡养鹌鹑，最后发现养鹌鹑的话翻得最快。我们自己养，还教周边的农民来养，我们还带动了100个、1000个、10000个人养鹌鹑。有一段时间呢，我们的县成了全世界最大的鹌鹑养殖基地，养了超过1000万只鹌鹑。从最开始的收入高一些，那个有衣服穿，有饭吃，不再挨饿，到后边的受人尊敬，到后边的能够为中国农村的面貌的变化做一点我们的自己的贡献。
In the 1990s, when suddenly the market opened up, everybody jumped in the market. So you had almost a kind of extreme entrepreneurialism.
You're moving from a lifetime employment system where a lot of your choices were made for you to a system which is much more market determined.
By the early 1990s, China's market economy was booming. But with a population now exceeding 1 billion,feeding the nation was still a big challenge.
China doesn't have very much arable land.
Farmers were feeling the pressure. At New Hope, urgent demand for their animal feed was skyrocketing.
所以说那个时候商品极其短缺，为了买我们的饲料要排队，排一个小时，排一天，排十天，排15天，最后呢，要买我们的饲料买不到，把我们的门仓都挤坏了。
Yung Hao was determined to ramp up his business. He thought science and technology held the key. Looking for answers, he headed west.
那个时候，在我12岁的时候，我父亲和他的兄弟去美国，其实是学习现代农业是怎么样的。
我看见这个大的饲料生产企业，他们研究院建得非常好，研究怎么样提高饲料的利用率，研究怎么样提高我们这种玉米黄豆的生长的每亩的产出，研究怎么样提高它们的价值。所以说我们在中国也开始做一些研究，我们在中国建饲料研究中心，我们请了很多专家，也跟大学合作，我们都特别的努力，靠我们的双手，当然也靠中国这种允许干、允许试这样的一个政策，我们才有逐步的进步和成长。
China in the 1990s was a hotbed of new businesses, busy making consumer products.Which few could afford just a decade before.
TVEs were now industrializing the countryside, and all of that lifted living standards.
You see a dramatic change in what I call the lifestyle, the consumption habits of the Chinese.
A bicycle, a television set, refrigerators, maybe a motorbike if you were feeling particularly adventurous.
In Jiangsu province, Gao Derkeng's clothing business was building momentum.With a new product, state-of-the-art down clothing.
那我认为一辈子只要做一张事，我是做好羽绒服装。现在我的想法要实现了。
Derkeng decided to start his own brand, Boisodon, but things didn't go to plan.
One of the expressions that's used to talk about entrepreneurship.In China, is the expression "xia hai," jumping into the sea, because it suggests that on one level, it's a very exhilarating, exciting thing to do, but also that it's risky.
1993呢，我们做的应该说很好的，它好了以后呢，人类就发松了，我们不是出去市场没调研， 我们只有销了8万斤，是23万斤销了8万斤，15万斤的质押，那个时候是非常紧张，因为银行有800万贷款造了房子啊等等，这里边已经样子摆出来了，真的是。那个时候晚上，我刚才是5个晚上睡着醒过来，一身冷汗，睡着醒过来一身冷，这个焦急和焦虑啊，这个比死还难受，我告诉你，这完全压力，这种责任感、责任心，压力这种一个组织的一个做了多少年，他对你的一个人的面子，什么都计较一些，你那个时候头要发胀。
The fact is that jumping into the sea in real life is something that you don't know what will happen. You may get eaten by a shark.
德肯 worked hard to get his business back on track.
一个那个政策这样好的政策没有做好，不能让它再有这样出现。葡萄园我们才知道，我们怎么样要通过创新让消费者非常喜欢我们波士顿品牌。
Within 5 years, Boisdon was China's leading producer of down clothing.
我们一共有6个生产基地。我们有2万多名员工，那挺好。你这个活是比较累的活，拉链装起来它拉不着呢，就是你在这个里边的碰到一定要知道。
德康 has achieved all he's ever dreamed of, and thanks to the growth of his business, others have shared in his success.
也是我拿了9000100，我把这个家乡的房子都集结到一起，使他们跟着像城里人生活一样。这我们城里现在有1700多人，我们的房子呢建了我一共427栋。我感觉到我爸爸妈妈生我养我的城，如果我自己能力有自己能力去帮助人家，不去帮助，那我算什么呢？我妈妈呢是这样，我记着生了我，给了我成熟的一种对人要一个真心诚意，要有责任心，要有等于自己爱别人。我就是实际上我现在做的一切都是从她身上来。以后不管怎么样成功，我永远不会忘记我的家乡，因为生我养我的地方，我永远不会忘记我是个农民的儿子。
The Chinese are naturally entrepreneurial.The genetic code had never been lost. And so when they had the chance again to be entrepreneurs, they did it.
The reforms of 1978 were just the beginning. Since then, ever-deepening reform has enabled people in China's countryside to create new jobs, enjoy more varied lives, and experience a prosperity their grandparents could only dream of.
China's on the brink of eradicating extreme poverty.
It's a remarkable story. Some 700 million people in China have been lifted out of poverty over the last 40 years. Actually, that's the most remarkable reduction in poverty in world history.
But there's still a lot of work to do.
There's a huge range of development experiences. And I think a major challenge for China is how do you share that prosperity more evenly across the whole country.
In some rural areas, poor land and lack of skills have held back progress for some.
First time, the other people said, who is this? Oh, that guy, that guy, that guy, that guy, that guy.有种故事嘛啦，锄禾日当午，还得喝下桶。这家伙，这可是哪还？说明是过去是没那自来水没安，现在就带水去那个下坡，加上两个桶，哎呀，那他那会儿那是那有点缺水。
Despite the new opportunities springing up.Life here in rural Shanxi was still very poor when Li Jin was growing up.
当年就是街上街上，要想反正第一次见了以后看着人反正挺憨厚啊，人挺老实，还不会乱说人，只要讲话第一次见面肯定你。
这都是
你对中山
说的。都是在作业啊、裤子啊、鞋。
都是谁照顾
多少钱？
哦。每个人都有，都有那结婚时候都有的手段、化妆间、指甲剪。
有点。
Even today, villagers like Li Jin and his wife have found themselves left behind.
年年人家是这么年年做的，他们也知道，收入不大。
The rural areas are still significantly worse off than the urban areas. Interior areas have pockets and regions which have been left behind.
Economic growth and economic development is much less strong than it is in the more prosperous and more urbanized parts of China.
The extremely poor tend to be people who don't have a lot of education or skills, meaning it's harder to move into paid work. So if you're stuck in subsistence agriculture, that makes it difficult to escape poverty.
In 2015, Xi Jinping rolled out an ambitious program to help these struggling, left-behind poor. Purpose-built villages, with new job opportunities and more advanced farming methods, are part of a targeted approach to eradicate poverty altogether by 2020.
第一次听到那个就多少这个一地白起，我们的心情是非常高兴。
In the new village, Li Jin and his wife will still be farming, but in a way that produces a higher income.
People are still working with very basic skills, and they need to have employment, and they need to have a lifestyle that's suitable to their skill level and with their own vision of what they want for their life.
The good thing about the farm is that it can grow vegetables, and it can grow food.他一年四季可以种好几茬，每一年是弄种好几茬，反正能茬茬反正能提高效益。
The new village is also better connected, opening up markets as far away as Beijing for the villagers' organic produce.
China's infrastructure investment is enormous, and it has really been a crucial part of the rapid transformation of China, lifting.Hundreds of millions of people out of poverty. It's a really major
achievement. 这可是一开大门，叫嫂嫂聊哇哇的。
我首先你看昨天你说有只矿呢，这又不污染又不上楼，就是家你看躺地上都亮脏脏的。
那是个忘了，反正就是，就说我们算是个小鸡，你和你也不一样。但是我们村娃那个些小孩们，你来这里上学，我说一直就别意。
就是这一出嘛，就是广场舞不是？就是跳舞跳方便，做啥钱方便。
China's come such a long way since 1978.
The generation of the 1980s was worried about having a meal. Today, the young generation is completely different. It's about health food. It's about keeping fit. It's about, you know, eating organic.
As they've got richer, their population has become more aware, more demanding. They want their air clean. They want their food to be safe. They've become more vocal.
It's about the quality of life.
Farmer Yeo Mingrue has lived through every moment of China's transformation. In 1978, putting a meal on the table was a struggle.Now he works on a thriving farm where food quality is just as important as quantity.
We usually have this seed bag for 2 to 3 days. Each time, there are about 500 to 600. Then it's put into 4 boxes and sent to each
store. Ming Rui's son He Bing started the farm to rear animals and grow crops organically.
然后呢，就做我们店里面的那个炒鸡蛋，客人都特别喜欢吃。
The farm supplies ingredients for dishes at He Bing's chain of restaurants.
我们现在呢，在国内有12家餐厅，在马尼拉呢有4家餐厅。 作为来自江西农村的一个男孩，能够在北京留下来，能够开这些店，取得这些成就，我自己为自己感到自豪。我跟我父亲成长环境最大不同，我认为呢，要在土地上去种水稻啊，种棉花呀，然后呢，要通过土地来过日子。而我们呢，只要去好好读书，可以走出农村，去到我们喜欢的大城市，然后呢，去做喜欢的事情，然后改变自己的命运。
作为我一个这个农民的业主，能够在北京开店，真是很不容易。我看到他生意又可以，很开心了。现在我能为他帮一下，我就帮一下吧。
我女儿安杰拉，她很漂亮。小时候呢，她也比较既聪明也比较调皮，喜欢做她自己做的事儿。
Harnessing the talents of the next generation is key to the success of Chinese businesses. And that's why Yung Hao, founder of New Hope Group, always wanted his only daughter, Angela, to join the family firm. But trying to persuade her wasn't easy.
He said, I don't like raising chickens. I don't like making feed. I don't like smelling. Then I said, what do you like?
那我觉得我自己唱歌也不错，然后也很热爱。
我说唱歌不行了，我们需要你为我们的家庭，为我们的公司做贡献，希望呢你能够接我们的班。
后来其实我父亲很直接的打击了我这个梦想。我觉得好像有一个多月吧，没有跟我父亲说话。他总是跟我说实话，你没有任何一个最突出的地方，别人支持你，难道只是因为你有一个有钱的爸爸吗？
他说，另外呢，我有个想法，我想开一个时尚店，但是你得借点钱给我。通过开这个小店，后面呢，他还开过什么餐馆呐、这些，餐馆也做得很好，他懂得了跟别人合作。懂得了怎么样管理的财务，懂得了市场的一些经验。
Angela had got a taste for business, and in 2002, Yung Hao finally got what he wanted. Angela decided to join New Hope.
首先，新希望这个事业它的起点就是非常非常阳光、非常非常有未来的一个事业。
当然呢，我们有了梦想，不断去拼搏，不断去努力。中国现在正在提出农业的现代化。
Today, President Xi Jinping is encouraging the growth of larger, more efficient farms, and urges a greener, more scientific approach to agriculture.
我们希望帮助数以十万计的农民朋友，使他们成为新型的农村的叫做技术人员，或者是新型的农民。我们认为我们很多年轻人希望国家越来越好，希望自己越来越富裕，希望我们能够过上好日子。所以说我们的集团就取名叫希望集团。
China's countryside has transformed since 1978.Yet rural life remains for many a nostalgic link to the past. And this offers rural areas a great business opportunity.
As China's middle class became much more numerous and much richer by the early 21st century, Chinese people started going on holiday.
And now you have a huge amount of domestic tourism.
Some travel to enjoy China's extraordinary natural beauty.While others seek out its traditional cultures.
我们葛头村这的村民还在保持着原来的生活方式。
Goto in Guizhou province only draws a small number of visitors each year. Attracting more tourists could revitalize the local economy.Today, Chang Zhen and Qing are going to Langda, a Miao village where tourism is flourishing, to try to learn from their success.
我觉得你们非要按照我的你叫了这个，我说的假，那个说你去那谁有啊？谁有啊？我觉得干那，如果你们非要按照我的你叫了这个，我说的假，谁有啊？我觉得干那，如果你们非要按照我的你叫了这个，我说的假，谁有啊？我觉得干那，如果你们非要按照我的你叫了这个，我说的假，谁有啊？我觉得干那，如果你们非要按照我的你叫了这个，我说的假，谁有啊？我觉得干那，如果你们非要按照我的你叫了这个，我说的假，谁有啊？我觉得干那，如果你们非要按照我的你叫了这个，我说的假，谁有啊？我觉得干那，如果你们非要按照我的你叫了这个，我说的假，谁有啊？我觉得干那，如果你们非要按照我的你叫了这个，我说的假，谁有啊？我觉得干那，如果你们非要按照我的你叫了这个，我说的假，谁有啊？我觉得干那，如果你们非要按照我的你叫了
还有那老师叫学了啥，谁教还学学，今后面别的那老好了，我就那教了啥个不是，老姐姐又能在后面别了的。
China in 1978 was one of the poorest countries on earth. Today, China is a middle-income country, the second biggest economy in the world, and is on the brink of eradicating extreme poverty.
How did China succeed? The answer is it succeeded in its own way.
Many people, when they think about economic and social change in China, think about the cities, but the really significant changes were in the countryside.
Farmers grab new opportunities.
The desire to escape from poverty is really huge.
Risked everything.
我担当的是，我如果做不好，连家都没了。那我这样的话，我对自己没退路。
They experimented and innovated.
Young people are thinking outward and beyond.
在国际上面，我们也希望能够代表中国。
People have kept looking forward.
All they know is transformation, is that life tomorrow will be different from life today or yesterday.
只要自己愿意，自己愿意付出努力，可以做自己喜欢的东西，这是最大的不同。
这也是我们的梦想，让农民过上城市人一样的好日子。
The journey has already been extraordinary. But for China and her people, the adventure into the future continues.